लेक्चर नंबर 7। बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक ऑफ एडवांस्ड मटेरियल्स इन इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। In this perspect, we will study some intrinsic and extrinsic properties. Intrinsic property. An intrinsic property is an essential or inherent property of a material itself or within. It means that it is the property which is inherited property of a material due to its own composition. It is independent of how much of the material is present and is independent of the form of the material. This property is independent of the amount of the material and form of the material. For example, color, mass, density, flexibility, and hardness. They are all intrinsic properties. The intrinsic properties do not change with the substance in small or large amount. If the substance is either in small amount or large amount, these properties do not change. These properties are independent from the amount of the substance, but they are dependent mainly on the chemical composition or structure of the material. Intrinsic properties are dependent mainly on the fundamental composition and structure of the material. For example, graphene is basically a single atomic layer of graphite, an allotropic form of carbon that is made up of very tightly bonded carbon atoms organized into a hexagonal lattice. As we know that graphene is an allotropic form of carbon in which carbon atoms are tightly bonded with each other in a hexagonal manner, just like graphite. Basically, it is the one or single layer of graphite. The intrinsic properties of graphene makes it so special that separate it from other forms of carbon. Graphene has exceptional intrinsic properties. It has special property due to which it has separate position from the other allotropic forms of carbon. These intrinsic properties of graphene are stiffness, strength, toughness, which make graphene stand out both as an individual material and as a reinforcing agent in composites. These three properties, stiffness, strength and toughness. Graphene has high values for these three properties, and due to these three properties, graphene is widely used as a independent material, as well as it is used in different composites. It means that it is mixed with other materials to form another material of desired properties. Stiffness. The breaking force obtained experimentally is equal to 340 plus minus 50 Newton per meter. This is the value for stiffness for graphene, and this value is about 340 to plus minus 50 Newton per meter. This value has been confirmed by experiments. Strength. Defect free monolayer graphene is considered to be the strongest material with a strength of 42 Newton per meter. It means that the single layer of graphene is very strong material. If it is defect free, then it has a very high strength value, that is equal to 42 Newton per meter. Toughness. Fracture toughness is one of the most important mechanical property of graphene and is measured as a critical stress intensity factor, that is equal to 4 plus minus 0.6 megapascal. 1 megapascal is equal to 10 bar. The third mechanical property of graphene is fracture toughness. It has also very high value. It is experimentally measured, it is equal to 4 plus minus 0.6 megapascal. 1 megapascal is equal to 10 bar. Now we study the semiconductors. Basically, they are also part of intrinsic materials. A semiconductor is a substance which has resistivity in between conductors and insulators. In other words, a semiconductor is a substance which is non-conductor at room temperature, but when the temperature is increased or when some impurity is added into it, it becomes a good conductor. Therefore, we can say that it is in between the conductors and insulators, that is called semiconductor. A semiconductor has negative temperature coefficient of resistance, which means the resistance of a semiconductor decreases with the increase in temperature and vice versa. A semiconductor has a negative temperature coefficient of resistance. It means that if we increase the temperature of a semiconductor,
its resistance will decrease, therefore, which results in the increase in the conductivity and vice versa. Second, when a suitable metallic impurity is added to a semiconductor, its current conducting property change appreciably. When an impurity is added into a pure or intrinsic semiconductor, it starts to conduct the electricity. It means that it becomes conductor. Types of semiconductors. There are two types of semiconductors. Number one, intrinsic semiconductors. Number two, extrinsic semiconductors. Intrinsic semiconductor. An intrinsic semiconductor is a pure semiconductor which does not have any doping agent or impurity. Doping agent means an impurity which is added to a semiconductor or a metalloid to increase its conductivity. In intrinsic semiconductors, the number of charge carrier depends upon property of the material, not on impurity present. Since the intrinsic semiconductors are pure metalloids, therefore the number of charge carriers depends upon property of the material and not on the impurity present. It means that in intrinsic semiconductor, which is a pure metalloid, the number of charge carrier depends upon the pure atoms of the metalloid. Intrinsic semiconductor has little current conduction capability at room temperature. It means that at room temperature it cannot conduct the electricity. It is non-conductor at room temperature. Some of the metalloids such as silicon, germanium, tin, selenium and tellurium, they are intrinsic semiconductor, which means that the pure substance can exhibit semiconducting property. It means that when these metalloids are in pure form, they are non-conductors. But if an impurity is added into them, they become conductors. The conductivity of silicon can be enhanced with the addition of small amount of dopants that increase the number of charge carriers. It means that when we add an impurity into silicon, that impurity will have free electrons, which are the charge carrier. Therefore, the number of charge carriers increases by addition of an impurity or dopant to silicon. As a result, the conductivity of silicon increases. extrinsic semiconductors. An extrinsic semiconductor is a semiconductor whose electrical conductivity can be increased by adding the trace amount of other elements such as impurities in the material. It means that when a semi-metal or metalloid is in pure form, it is called intrinsic material or intrinsic semiconductor. When an impurity is added to a semi-metal or metalloid, so it becomes a good conductor. This type of semiconductor containing the impurity is called extrinsic semiconductor. There are two types of impurities added to silicon or germanium crystals. Because these are in pure form, they are semi-metals and they are intrinsic semiconductor. But when we add impurity, we can add two type of impurity. Number one, pentavalent material like arsenic or antimony. When it is added to the semi-metal like silicon or germanium, it becomes good conductor, because arsenic and antimony, they are pentavalent elements. They have 5 electrons in their valence shell, and when they are added as an impurity, they use 4 electrons to form covalent bond with germanium or silicon. One remaining electron is responsible, which can jump from valence shell of arsenic or antimony to the conduction band of germanium or silicon. As a result, the germanium or silicon becomes negatively charged, and it is called an n-type semiconductor. Similarly, we can add trivalent material. It is the material which has 3 valence electrons, like gallium, indium, thallium. All these elements have 3 electrons in their valence shells. When they are added as impurity to silicon or germanium, they make them good conductor, because they have valence shells or valence orbitals which have very close energy to the valence band of germanium or silicon. As a result, the electron can jump from semi-metals to the vacant orbitals of gallium, indium or thallium. As a result, the silicon or germanium become positively charged. Therefore, this type of material is called p-type semiconductor, because p for positive, because it results in the form of positive charge on germanium or silicon. For example, in silicon crystal, if we replace one of these silicon atoms with an arsenic atom, the conductivity would increase, because the lattice acquires an extra electron. As a result, it becomes negatively charged. Therefore, we can call it as n-type semiconductor. There is no room for the extra electron from the arsenic atom to occupy molecular orbitals in the valence band of the silicon, so they occupy a very narrow set of orbitals of their own. The arsenic orbital energies are intermediate between those of the valence band and conduction band of silicon as shown in figure 11.5a. Therefore, the electron can jump from the impurity or arsenic to the conduction band of the silicon, making it n-type semiconductor. Similarly, if we add gallium or indium or thallium, they are all trivalent elements. When we add them to silicon, they have three electrons in their valence shell. Their energy of the valence shell is very close to the valence band of silicon. Therefore, electron can jump from valence band of silicon to the vacant orbital of trivalent element like gallium, indium or thallium. As a result, silicon becomes positively charged. Therefore, we can call it as p-type semiconductor. This is shown in figure 11.51b. This is the figure 11.51. If we see the picture, we observe that from the left hand side in the first column, the purple colored band is called the vacant or valence band. The upper one is combined CB or it is also called the conduction band, because electrons can jump from valence band to conduction band. AB, the difference between an intrinsic semiconductor and n-type semiconductor and a p-type semiconductor. This is the intrinsic semiconductor, the left one. The middle line represents the n-type semiconductor, in which when we add an impurity into a pure metalloid, it has its valence orbital energy near to conduction band. Therefore, the electrons can jump from impurity to conduction band. This jump of electrons from impurity to the conduction band is responsible for the conductivity of the semiconductor. This type of impurity is called donor. They are called donors because they donate electron to the pure metalloid. As a result, the negative charge on the semi-metal increases. Therefore, it is called negative type semiconductor or n-type semiconductor. In the second type, if we add such an impurity to the metalloid, that impurity has vacant orbital which have close energy to the valence band of the metalloid, the electron can jump from valence band to the vacant orbital of the impurity.
here since the impurity has vacant energy levels which are very close to the valence band of the metalloid, therefore these are called acceptors. As a result, when electron jumps from valence band of the metalloid to impurity, the metalloid has positive charge. It becomes positively charged because it loses the electron. As a result, the metalloid becomes positively charged. Therefore, it is called P-type semiconductor or positively charged semiconductor. Next, we study doping. Doping means addition of impurity to a semiconductor. Semiconductors can become conductors. To make the semiconductors to conduct electricity, other atoms called impurities must be added. This process is called doping. It means that addition of an impurity to a semiconductor or metalloid make the semiconductor to conduct the electricity. This process is called doping. Impurities are different elements. Basically, these impurities are also pure elements. They are either from group 3 or group 5 of the periodic table. An impurity or element like arsenic has 5 valence electrons. Adding arsenic, doping or impurity, will allow 4 of the arsenic valence electrons to bond with the neighboring silicon atoms. The one electron left over for each arsenic atom becomes available to conduct current flow. As it is earlier explained that when we add arsenic to pure silicon, arsenic has 5 electrons in its valence shell. 4 out of these 5, 4 electrons are involved with the covalent bond formation with the surrounding silicon atoms. The remaining one electron is responsible for the conductivity of the material because it can move freely from lower shell to higher shell. The silicon doped with extra electron is called an n-type semiconductor. N is for negative, which is charge of an electron. It means that if we add arsenic or antimony to silicon, arsenic and antimony, they belong to group 5. When they are added to silicon, they make the silicon good conductor because these impurities, arsenic and antimony, have one extra electron which can jump from their valence shell to the higher or the conduction band of the silicon. It means that whenever we add arsenic or antimony to silicon, n-type semiconductor is formed because this semiconductor is negatively charged.
silicon dope with material missing electrons that produce location called hole is called p-type semiconductor. If we add an element from group 3 like indium, gallium or thallium to silicon, they have valence shell which are vacant and which have energy just closer to the valence shell of the silicon. Therefore, the electron can jump from silicon to the valence shell of group 3 elements like gallium, indium or thallium. As a result, the silicon become positively charged. Therefore, this type of semiconductor is called p-type semiconductor. P is for positive, which is the charge of the hole, because when electron leaves silicon atom and goes to the valence shell of the gallium, indium or thallium, it leaves a positive charge on the silicon. Therefore, this is called p-type semiconductor. N-type as well as p-type semiconductor is electrically neutral. Overall, these type of conductors, they are neutral ones. Now we will study the applications or uses of semiconductors. Semiconductors are used in almost all electrical devices. Without them, our life would be much different. It means that without semiconductors, our life will be different. Number one, transistors, diodes, photosensors, microcontrollers, integrated chips and much more are made up of semiconductors. All the transistors, diodes, photosensors, microcontrollers, integrated chips and all such type of materials, they are made up of semiconductors. Number two, temperature sensors are made with semiconductor devices. It means that the temperature sensors which measure the temperature of different materials are made up of semiconductor devices. Number three, semiconductors are used in three-dimensional printing machines. Number four, they are used in microchips and self-driving cars. Number five, they are used in calculators, solar plates, computers and other electronic devices. Number six, transistor electrical circuits are manufactured using semiconductors. Number seven, the physical and chemical properties of semiconductors make them capable of designing technological wonders like
microchips, transistors, LEDs, solar cells, etc. It means that all these type of materials like microchips, transistors, LEDs, solar cells, they are made up of semiconductors because of their properties. Number 8, the microprocessor used for controlling the operation of space vehicles, trains, robots and other controlling devices are manufactured by semiconductors materials. Number 9, semiconductors are specially made up of gallium and arsenic. They are called gallium arsenide. They are used mainly for optoelectronics. It means they are used in optoelectronics, mean like telescopes, etc. Number 10, computer memory is made up of semiconductor material because it provides reliability. CPU contains number of integrated circuits which are made up of semiconductor materials. It means that computer memory chips like USB and other devices, memory devices, they are all made up of semiconductors due to their reliability. Similarly, many parts of CPU contains integrated circuits made up of semiconductors. Number 11, CPU contains number of integrated circuits which are made up of semiconductor materials. This is all about the intrinsic and extrinsic materials. Thank you very much.